Red Heart, hello guys, welcome to the stream. Please like, comments and subscribe Red Heart.
Please enter username. Finally.
Welcome to WWE 2K22. My name is Drew Gulak. You know me as a technical genius in the ring, but what you may not know is that I'm also a genius when it comes to training WWE superstars. I've elevated countless careers. The results speak for themselves. Today, I'm here to train you. You probably think you already know everything. But let me tell you, you don't. How to be a great wrestler. Rey Mysterio, one of the greatest talents to ever set foot into the ring. A genuine legend. But his 619s, springboards, splashes from the top rope. How many times have you seen these moves backfire? That's because they're too flashy. They are unpredictable. No way. Throw all of that stuff in the garbage. We're gonna focus on the foundations. My training, your help, we're gonna show Rey Mysterio how to be a winner. The Gulak way. I'll see you out there.
The key to any wrestler's success is strong fundamentals. Nobody knows more about fundamentals than me, and I'm gonna teach you. Let's start with basic offense, strikes and grapples, and show some aggression. Light strikes are the fastest moves you have. Use them to open your opponent's defenses. Heavy attacks deal big damage. Capitalize on openings with a big, heavy strike. Grappling is the most important skill for any wrestler. Use it to control space and reposition your opponent. Hey, look at you. You can do the bare minimum. All right, on to the next section. Mix up your combos to stay one step ahead of your opponent. Yeah. Let's see your form on defense. After you block a strike, try hitting your opponent with a light attack to gain the advantage. Sometimes the best defense is just getting out of the way. Dodge an incoming attack to gain a... Reversals are all about timing. Try to reverse right before you get hit to counter. Reversals have a small window of success, but they can change the momentum of a match in an instant. You will learn this one way or another.
And I was trying for that signature move.
You may need flashy. I guess you can still teach an old dog new tricks, huh? Even a very, very old dog like you. If you're on defense in a combo or grab, press the same attack button as your opponent to counter the move. There are countless styles of professional wrestling, but only one of them is the best. My way.
Man, I don't get this. What we have to do? When struck by a combo, predict the next move.
I expected a legend to pick this up quicker. You can block strikes, but not grabs. Try to guess which one your opponent will use next. All right, now we're talking. Now that you know the basics, let's simulate a real match. You've got a full finisher meter, which means you have access to your best move. Maybe something tasteful, like an armbar. That was not part of our training. You can't do that. Ref, he's not allowed to do that.
Your winner, Rey Mysterio!
I know you're a legend, but now that you're working with Drew Gulak, imagine the heights you'll reach. Coming to me was the best decision you ever made.
In a universe populated by
So you want to be a general manager for the greatest sports entertainment company in the world. I've been in this industry my whole life, seen many come and go. And now here you are taking your first step into the mix. Tell me, what are you looking for? Fame? Glory? Prestige? What kind of a general manager will you become? Have you thought about that? Will you be a fair and balanced overseer? Or maybe you'll rule your roster with an iron fist. Either way, one thing you need to do is make impact. I didn't start my career in the WWE as a general manager like you're about to. I had to earn my spot through years and years of dedication to this business. But you?
Monday Night Raw, ready to make their first pick.
I'd like to officially welcome our newest recruit to the start of his WWE journey.
You come into our sport, think it's going to be easy, but you're for a real wake-up call.
If you ask me, I think he's going to do big things here.
Look out, Superman punch! That shovel's an equalizer. Spear! Spear!
This is going to be one for the ages.
We are going to give you the foundation to succeed in WWE. What you do with it is up to you.
So this is it. Day one of training at the WWE Performance Center. As you can see, it looks like everyone heard I was coming and decided they'd be better off staying home. This is cool. But there's no way my journey ends here. I'm going to WWE and then straight to the top, where I make sure
that— What are you doing? You're an hour and a half early for your orientation.
I was just checking out the facility.
There'll be plenty of time for that later. How did you even get in here?
Guy up front let me in.
Oh, big guy with the mustache? Kinda sweaty?
Yep.
Well, that's Todd's final strike. Hope he enjoys early retirement.
Oh, no need to get anyone in trouble. He, definitely checked my ID and even did a pat-down. Really thorough. So Todd's all right in my book. I feel very safe in his big, sweaty hands.
Fine, whatever. Anyway, you're going to need to fill out your information on this and sign a bunch of waivers before you can begin training today. And when you're done with all that, there's actually a fun part. You get to design your wrestling gear in case you become a WWE superstar.
You mean when I become a WWE superstar?
Yeah, sure. Wait, have you been filming this entire time?
Is that a problem?
Filming's not allowed in here without prior consent, which you should have been told by security. Frickin' Todd! Turn it off, please.
Thank you.
You done with all that yet?
Just finished. It takes time to design a look like that.
I've seen worse.
So now what? Should I go wait at the front desk with you until it's time to start?
Front desk? What do you think I do here? I'm Corey Klein, head recruiter and occasional babysitter of people who don't follow instructions and show up way earlier than they're supposed to.
Oh, that Corey. I guess when we were emailing, I just saw your name and assumed that... You know what? It's nice to meet you in person, finally.
Go get changed. Then head over to the gym. The other trainees who started last week should be showing up soon. And to clear up any potential confusion on your end, they are men.
Got it. Thanks.
Hey, new guy, right? I'm Hector Flores. Welcome to the PC.
Thanks. I'm excited to get going, especially since I heard you started last week.
Started here, at least. I've been training in wrestling for years before this. It's part of growing up in Mexico.
Are you from one of those famous wrestling families?
No, where I'm from, you were either into wrestling or football. Sorry, soccer. I chose wrestling.
I chose football. American, to be clear. I had no interest in all that running they do in soccer. Plus, I love the physicality of football.
I can see how that relates to wrestling, but how'd you end up here?
Football is a team sport, and I don't play well with others. Just ask any of my former teammates what happened when they pissed me off.
So athletic guy who can't control his temper wants to find new way to get paid. Is that about right?
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up. That okay with you?
I guess we'll find out.
Hey, who are you?
First day training here. It's nice to meet you in person. Since I transitioned from football to wrestling, I've been watching a lot of your matches from Japan. And when I heard you were here, I was pumped to get in the ring with you.
Yeah, well, you better act fast since I don't plan on being here too long.
Why is that?
Because they should have never sent me here to begin with. I don't belong in the same place as someone just crossing over from football or some stupid former mascot. If you haven't met that goon yet, don't bother.
You know who else crossed over from football? Steve Austin, The Rock, Roman Reigns. And I'm gonna be bigger than all of them.
Bigger tool? Maybe. Bigger star? No chance. For every success story, there's 1,000 guys that never made it. Like I said, I don't plan on being here very long. But I look forward to making sure you end up in the category no one's heard of.
Too late, because a lot more people have watched me line up on Saturdays and Sundays than have ever seen you wrestle. Just because I'm new to this game doesn't mean I haven't played the game. Don't test me, or you won't like the results.
I heard you were starting today. Big fan.
Thanks. You're a football fan?
No, not really. I just like your team's colors. Big purple fan. That'll be the color of my gear when I get to WWE. But anyway, I actually have an athletic background too. I spent some time in minor league baseball.
Really? Who'd you play for?
Well, I wasn't a player. I was actually a mascot named Ribby. But I was around a ton of good athletes.
Oh, okay. Well, that counts for something, I guess.
The best part of the job was they used to have indie wrestling shows at the stadium all the time, where I got to rub elbows with legends like Jerry the King Lawler. He found out I was training on the side as a wrestler and actually helped me get a shot here. Not that I couldn't have made it on my own.
Even if Lawler helped get your foot in the door, you wouldn't be here if you weren't talented. I'll see you out there in a bit.
Ah, sounds good, buddy. Oh, and before I forget, can you sign your football card for me before you leave today?
Sure. Just as long as you don't sell it online.
Ah, well, then you know what? I can get it some other time.
I'm just messing with you. If you can make a few bucks, then good for you. And literally, it might only be a few bucks. See you out there, Chase.
I'd like to officially welcome our newest recruit to the start of his WWE journey. The rest of you have heard this speech already, so we'll try to make it quick.
On our first day, he did the whole ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages thing. It was awesome.
We'll do the talking, Chase.
I was just telling him about your cool DX intro you did.
Chase!
What Road Dogg was getting at is we are going to give you the foundation to succeed in WWE. What you do with it is up to you.
Keep in mind, you will be judged at all times. The big man in the sky is always watching.
Not that big man. There's a camera up there with a live feed that goes directly to Triple H's office in Stamford.
The coaches and PC staff certainly have input, but ultimately, he'll decide when the time's right to bring the GMs from NXT, Raw, and SmackDown here so you can showcase your talents.
I'm ready for that now.
Yeah, we know you think that, but it's not your call, Big Shot.
Okay, now that all that's out of the way, we're gonna start with some one-on-one matches to see where everyone's at.
All right, new guy, since it's your first day, we'll let you choose who you want to face.
Okay, let's get started.
Hyphen my private photo here, Red Heart. Hyphen my private photo here, Red Heart. Hyphen my private photo here.
Seven! Eight! Nine! Ten! Okay, ring the bell!
Before you say anything, do you really think you just got everything I had? It's obvious I shouldn't be here. So I'm not gonna give 100% in a training match against a nobody.
Is that what you're gonna tell Triple H? Because he probably want an explanation for why the hottest free agent signing since AJ Styles just lost to a nobody.
Triple H wasn't watching our match. The coaches just say that to scare you rookies.
You think so? Cause I'm pretty sure after I beat you, I looked up at the camera and saw it zooming in on me. Probably Triple H wondering who this rookie was who just showed him they're wasting a crap ton of money on an overhyped bust.
Face me when it really counts, and we'll see what happens.
Here's the thing. I think it already did, and we saw what happened. But I'm happy to give Triple H a replay anytime.
Hey, big news. We got another member of DX coming to help out for a bit at
the... Hornswoggle?
No. One of the members of the best version of DX, X-Pac.
No offense, but I actually think the original version of DX was the best.
Wow. Offense taken. It's funny, Sean always tells me the same thing.
You guys were cool, but... Sean and Hunter were the OGs.
Okay. What if when X-Pac is here, we had a match to settle this debate? You and your OG hero, Shawn Michaels, versus me and X-Pac.
Don't need to have a match because I already know the original is better.
Whatever. I guess I'll see if Hornswoggle's available. Hey, big news.
You know, I have to agree that the DX you were a part of was the best.
Damn straight it was. But you know who disagrees? Sean.
You guys took what they started and made it 10 times better.
That's what I always say. Anyway, what if when X-Pac is here, we had a match to settle this debate? You?
That sounds cool, but unless Triple H was involved, I don't see how it's really settling anything.
Whatever. I guess...